Well, there's all kinds of that kind of stuff. You're exactly right. There's, you know, you have to think, well, here we are, we have these chromosomes, right? And we have all these genes on the chromosomes. It's silly to think that they don't have some impact. They do, how we use nutrition. And there's actually a new science out now called epigenetics. There's a whole science out now where back in the 1960s when I was doing these autopsies and writing articles saying, hey, these diseases have a nutritional deficiency element to them, they're just calling me a fool and a liar and a nut. Well, today they're saying, well, we have a new science now that shows that by supplementing with these nutrients, you can, in fact, prevent a genetic disease from manifesting itself. You can take a disease that was thought to be 100% genetic, and you can give these nutrients. And we're talking about muscular dystrophy. That's an easy one.
By the way, all three times my wife has been pregnant, we go in, you know, we allow the one ultrasound, even though it's probably not good, but at the end of the second trimester, and then they say, let us do genetic testing. We say no, but and then they advertise, because if we learn what the genetic triggers are and predispositions, there are mineral things and basically pharma, you know, big pharma is now creeping in, kind of admitting this. And saying then you can, we can recommend things you take that then will block that in you or your child. Also, as you know, doctor, more and more big pharma's coming in and trying to patent vitamin D and then put out a pharmaceutical grade. They're coming in now with regular female hormones with women that have, you know, low levels of progesterone that they would take as a supplement to not have miscarriages, and they're now patenting that and saying they're not going to let the compounding pharmacies put it out that have done such a good job. I mean, so they've been attacking vitamins and minerals from one end, but quietly they're trying to take it over and say nobody can sell these but us.
Well, exactly right. I'm the guy that sued the FDA to be able to say that omega-3s can prevent stroke and coronary thrombosis. I sued the FDA on that one, and now the pharmaceutical companies have come out with a prescription-grade omega-3, and it's like 150 times the cost of what ours is. And then you have something like niacin, vitamin B3, which we know will lower your cholesterol levels. They've came out with Niaspan now, which is sort of a time-release niacin. They're charging you 150 times what we charge for niacin. And the vitamin D3, as you point out. And it's just kind of interesting that we do all the work, and they poo-poo us and say we're quacks, and then they put a little carbon unit on one end of the thing, insignificant, but they're manufacturing it, so to speak, and therefore they get the patent, and insurance will pay for their clunky little thing that's synthetic and not for the natural stuff.
Okay, now, doctor, racing through this, tell us from the research, and as we do it, my team can just put it in Google and pull up mainstream news confirming it. That's what we've been doing here if you're a radio listener. But just type in whatever I say, and then you can pull it up for yourself. You know, main line, this is not even hidden. Race through some of the other mineral and cofactor deficiencies that are the triggers or one of the big things contributing towards many of these chronic diseases that are skyrocketing.
Okay. Well, let's say, you know, Elizabeth Taylor just died of congestive heart failure, which is a simple thiamine deficiency, vitamin B1. I get thousands of people off the heart transplant list every year by giving them the Alex pack and throwing in what we call de-stress capsules. Two capsules give you 3,000 times the minimum daily requirement of B1. And B1 deficiency, thiamine deficiency, can cause congestive heart failure and also a disease, a dementia that looks exactly like Alzheimer's disease. It's called Korsakoff syndrome. And so we can get rid of that disease. That one you can get rid of in 2 weeks, called Korsakoff syndrome.
That's right, because they admit that they will mislabel things as new diseases or another disease when they know full well it's a vitamin or mineral deficiency syndrome.
You're exactly right, Alex. And then, of course, muscular dystrophy, we got rid of the animal industry because muscle is meat, and Jerry Lewis is still running around there. I love him. I'm sure the medical system is duping him, that he doesn't realize that for 54 years we've already known the cause, prevention, and cure of muscular dystrophy. That's a simple deficiency of the trace mineral selenium during pregnancy. And then when you go to, again, menopause and the progesterone, there's actually a 150-year-old formula. It's a herbal formula. It was called Lydia Pinkham's back 150 years ago. Today it's called Woman's FX, and you can get it through the InfoWarsTeam.com. It's called Woman's FX. It actually gets women to slide through menopause very quickly, very healthily. They do have to eat about 4 to 6 eggs a day to get enough cholesterol so they can make their progesterone and their estrogens. And then there's erectile dysfunction in men. That's a new disease. That's actually a cholesterol deficiency.
What about thyroid?
Low thyroid is actually a deficiency not only of iodine, but the people forget, Alex, that your thyroid gland needs all 90 essential nutrients that's actually in the Alex pack. And the medical system is focused on iodine because it's the metal that's actually on the carbon chain to make the thyroid hormone. But your thyroid really needs the other 89 nutrients as well. So,
and if you don't have those, explain to people that the thyroid will grab other toxic things in the environment that they use, like in white flour. Break down, if you don't give your thyroid what it needs, what it does.
Okay, well, it'll get goiter. You actually get this huge, sort of grapefruit-sized thyroid gland that's non-functional called goiter, and all you have to do is give the nutrients, it goes away. But this is, you hit the nail on the head again for what's pertinent now, because we're now getting radioactive iodine. This was just on the news on the Fox crawler here that they're finding now radioactive iodine from the rain fallout in our kids' milk, in the milk supply now in the United States from this thing in Japan. They found it today, radioactive iodine, and this will be rapidly taken up by the thyroid gland of these kids and put them at high risk for thyroid cancer. And we have to get these kids to supplement properly with the Alex pack. And I would also throw in what we call Ocean's Gold or Cell Shield RTQ. These are things that have the normal organically bound iodine with plant material. They're organically bound. And once the thyroid gland has those, it will not be eager to take up the radioactive iodine. So it's a protection. That's why I call it cell shield.
So you're saying from your research, they don't need generally the big mega dose of the medical grade iodine, that even lower levels will keep it from wanting to absorb as much of this?
Oh, exactly. So if you take these nutrients, the Alex Pack and Cell Shield RTQ, Ocean's Gold, if you take these things every day, then you don't have to worry about this low-grade radioactive iodine.
And by the way, you keep saying Alex Pack. To explain that, when we got together with you guys, and I really believe in it, so I'm pushing it, at InfoWarsTeam.com, the Alex Pack is the name of a discounted package of what you believe is basically everything they need. Now, tell folks what's in the Tangy Tangerine, beyond Tangy Tangerine, because that's what my wife and I just love. And I just got it in the house, set it there, didn't even, you know, sell her on it. And she's like, what is this stuff? I'm having incredible energy working out. She's a big workout person.
Okay. Well, usually, you know, the health nuts used to have to take 50 different bottles and take all their different vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin A, calcium. And what we've done and put it into one product using the same technology that has been used for coffee crystals, so that every crystal is identical. It's not like powder where there's variations in the value of the dust that's in there. Well, this is, every crystal is perfect, and it has 130 nutrients, vitamins, amino acids, and minerals, and it has 115 berries, fruits, and vegetables in it. Think of that, Alex. 115 berries, fruits, and vegetables. Most medical doctors can't name 10, let alone 115. And this gives you the antioxidant points to support your immune system and fend off a lot of these chronic diseases, including things like rheumatoid arthritis, which is an infection. Chronic things like irritable bowel syndrome, inflammatory bowel disease, lupus. There's a 41-year-old lady who died in Southside Chicago just a couple of days ago from lupus, a simple mineral deficiency disease. You take the Healthy Starter Pack, which is the Alex Pack, which has the Beyond Tangerine in it. It's got everything you need in there to prevent or reduce your risk of lupus. And so nobody should ever die of lupus. It's not an autoimmune disease. Your body's not attacking itself. It's a simple nutritional deficiency disease that results in a breakdown of connective tissue.
And this, so it's really a type of scurvy. They just rename it lupus.
Yeah, exactly. It's scurvy, fibromyalgia, sarcoidosis. All these are connective tissue diseases, including vitamin C, which is the big one for what we'd call...
By the way, two-time Nobel Prize winner, 50-something years ago, Linus Pauling...
Yep.
I mean, he confirmed that mega doses of naturally occurring vitamin C are magic. And I go back to this. The British, what was it, 300 years ago plus, they discovered the limeys. They were called limeys because, and the Spanish, everybody laughed at them, bags of lime, they would limes, they would put it in the rum, two parts water, one part rum, knowing that the sailors would only drink it because it was seen, you know, that kind of stuff was bad for you then. But the British Royal Academy of Sciences, they had secretly discovered this and actually kept it as a closely guarded secret why they made everybody drink limes. So you'd have a ship 10,000 miles away when it met with a Spanish galleon in the trading routes in the Indian Ocean, And they would be able to absolutely smash them because the Spanish or the Portuguese or the Dutch would be laying around half dead on the deck, and the Brits would pull up absolutely in great shape, ready to kill with their sabers in their hands because they were getting the vitamin C they needed.
And, well, also, as a result, Linus Pauling died at 94, 40 years longer than the average medical doctor, although the medical doctors poo-pooed him for taking all that vitamin C. So I'm on your side. I'm on Linus Pauling's side.
By the way, you know he was one of the discoverers of DNA as well, and a top eugenicist. So I guess in a way, they kind of got to him and said, look, don't give the slaves this info. Shut up.
Well, he actually was left out of the Nobel Prize, unfortunately, for the double helix thing.
But from my research, he was one of the guys that discovered it, yeah.
That's right. Actually, he came up with it first. The other guys just confirmed it, and they got the Nobel Prize. He should have gotten it for that.
Yeah, well, and by the way, that's in the encyclopedia, folks, if you want to pull that up. But he did get the other two. He had two he did get, though, correct?
Oh, yeah. His first one was actually for the enzymes inside the mitochondria's his enzyme chemistry. Not vitamin C, and the second one was the Peace Prize when he was against nuclear weapons.
That's right. Folks,
so
we're almost out of
time. Everybody thinks it was vitamin C.
Yeah, we're almost out of time here with Dr. Joel Wallach of InfoWarsTeam.com, the host of Dead Doctors Don't Lie. And you get great products. It also supports the broadcast. And if you want to sign up and get discounts, it's $10. Then you can sign other people up. So it's got that factor to it so we can promote this out. Just like 10, 15 years ago, you couldn't find organic food at a store or organic milk. Now people have demanded it. You can hardly find stuff at many stores that isn't organic. So they're trying to name stuff organic that isn't now because it's so popular. The point is, this is another revolution we can have. We've gone over the evidence. Almost everything Dr. Wallach's talked about, we've put up on the screen, mainstream news recently. He was just saying it back in the 60s and 70s because he was a big researcher, as you heard. I hope you'll get involved at InfoWarsTeam.com. And, obviously minerals and things are something we need. And when you take it in these liquid forms, you absorb a lot more of it than if it's in a pill form. Correct, Dr. Wallach?
You're exactly right. Liquid, and then, of course, the Beyond Tangerine are these NutriCrystals. They will instantize. You just put that little scoop in some room temperature water. It instantly goes into solution, and so now you have a liquid, which is predictable.
Absolutely.
And it has these 130 nutrients in it.
Dr. Wallach, thank you so much for joining us. InfoWarsTeam.com or 877-551-1301 if you've got any questions. Thank you, Dr. Wallach. We'll come back with some financial news. Visit InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. When you're on the site, you can also tune in 24 hours a day to my daily radio broadcast. There's also a free iPhone app to listen to the syndicated radio show when and where you want.